guessing Momo will be putting up. Yes. It has to be an XP lane blue here.
Mm-hmm. Right now, so. Right now, Gideon, I just hope that Alucard just becomes a Malaysia thing. Because Fredo starts off and then Orange. And then right now, Team Toda bringing in the Alucard in the world stage. We keep saying, Toda always brings in the... Okay.
What? You thought Malaysia was crazy, Philippines? They're looking down, they're like, bring it. Bring crazy over.
The word for crazy in Tagalog or Filipino is baliw. This is baliw dress.
This is gila.
Gila!
Gila right baliw. Now, okay, right now the Fremits just counted the glue, so I don't know how to feel about this, Gideon.
Me neither. It is. Yeah. It's just, it worked. This is one of the very few situations where the stars have aligned for crazy to be real. And I love it. I love it, and I can't wait to get this game started. It's going to be Todak from Malaysia versus the Filipino representatives in Onyx PH. Who is going to get on top? Because the winners of this, if Todak is able to win this game, they are almost securing that top spot. And more importantly, getting to the upper bracket. Onyx PH, they need to be competitive contenders. If they can get this win, the snowball and momentum will be on their side.
Of course, they have to face off against each other. So now we see it's Marky going up against Momo in the XP lane. If you thought the shuffling was done, well... Not quite so, says the Malaysians and the Filipinos. Dilarski moved over to the gold lane.
Oh, interesting.
It's a switch up.
Formaze is actually going to be the one playing the Brody, and Chico is going to be in the jungle with the Alucard. Kind of interesting. Thought it'd be the other way around, but let's see as Hatred already attacking Yums, forcing out a very early flicker here. Moon can only do so much. Naturally, the early stages of the game, it's going to be Onyx PH's mid laners who have more control.
I can already feel how some fans might be struggling to keep up, but yes, Gideon has already laid it down. There's a few layers of shuffling on the side of Todak, but for Onyx PH, it's really just that. It's just Dilarski and Marky switching up their initial lane, and we saw in the game prior that it kind of works. Maybe in the first 5 minutes, 6 minutes before the third turtle, before things turn into, you know, active team fights left and right, you kind of want to buy time for your gold lane and your XP lane. So now, yeah, Dilarski, he's going to have to face the music here. It's a tough laning matchup against Formaze. He's basically losing this 70-30.
Absolutely. But, you know, at least when Kyrie is pathing his way up towards that top side of the map, making sure that, you know, if anything were to happen, they don't want the outer forces to make a difference. They trust that Dilarski has the experience to hold against his own, even in a losing matchup. And especially when it's Brody versus Esmeralda, it's really not a lot of fun.
Oh... Looking at the bottom lane and the top lane right now, there's a mirror happening, and Yums going to be seeing Dilarski over there. Baloyski dispersing. Going to try to put some pressure on Moon.
Yep, hopefully it's going to be enough. As Moon now in some a lot of trouble, gets pulled by the Guiding Wing just in time to allow Chico to jump on towards the start of the pursuit. Does he have enough? Yes, he finds the first blood by Razor, and now attacking Baloyski, the superposition coming in from Kyrie. Going to be more than enough to push him away.
Is it just me or the stacks on the Alucard passive look kind of like Todak's logo?
Actually, that's a good point here,
right?
That's a very good point. That is true and accurate. The turtle slain here by the Singaporean tourism board as the mid lane gets absolutely demolished. That wave didn't even stand a chance against Hatred's power. But now Formaze actually losing his matchup a level up on this Esmeralda, as well as the rest of Onyx PH continue to push their advantage up towards the top side of the map.
We just left that matchup for what, a minute, maybe less? Uh-huh. And Dilarski has bullied Formaze away. I'm guessing that's just because Dilarski needed to get those hits in with the Avarice. And yeah, I said 70-30. Maybe I was being very generous. Maybe I was a little more optimistic for the Brody. But right now, fight breaking out.
Yep, Yums now taking the full damage. Circling Eagle is going to get pushing in into Dilarski and straight into the raw damage. But Yums manages to survive all of it with the help of Formaze. I mean, this is an interesting dive coming in from Onyx PH. I'm surprised they weren't able to get it, but well played to Yums for surviving.
Yums getting away might have been the last straw for Onyx PH. For what, two or three team fights back and back, Onyx couldn't finish the job. Mm-hmm. Onyx just put in the right amount of damage to make him go back, but not kill anyone. And that being said, 500 gold ahead, Todak is... I'm feeling that Chico guys might actually start invading here. He might, with the help of Momo, and even look, they're about to collapse. They're sandwiching the trio from Onyx Philippines in mid.
They're trying to bait something out here, and Chico realizes that as long as their supports open up the map, it's going to be a little difficult here, but Circling Eagle going to get on top of Loisky here. Kyrie having a fun time. He doesn't mind. He's just going to drop down the entropy. His hatred finds Nibiru's passion. He flickers forward to trade the kill, and Chico guys takes him out, but just a little too slow. It's a 2-for-1 trade. Now Loisky quickly flickers on out of there. Alucard unable to get the second part of his ult out.
2-for-1, I'd say that's worth it, especially given that Onyx PH, when it comes to the rotations, are falling behind. And this is why I'm talking about when I say Dolarski is such a great XP laner. Mm-hmm. Now technically a gold laner, he's so good at these isolation plays. He's keeping a Brody at bay. He's keeping a Brody at bay, and with even Yums threatening the Circling Eagle, Dolarski's like, okay, make my day. Come on, I have a flicker. You might even regret it.
Yep, throw something at me, and Yums, he's got to play this very, very carefully because every single time he uses... Wait, hold on. Dolarski now respecting Moon, but unfortunately, Turtle is going to be taken away by Onyx PH here. So the rest of the team pulls on back. Chico is going to have to continue and get some kind of snowball somewhere. He's got a little bit of it down, but the team fight coming in from Onyx PH is looking good. They want that mid lane. Yums goes in at the wrong time. The Circling Eagle punishing him and throwing him into the hands of Onyx Philippines. It's now they chase down Momo, who goes in with a split switch, gets on top of Marky here just to reset his life for a little bit. But Kyrie invading the jungle as much as he can. They finally go for the reset.
Small camps taken by Onyx PH. This is the best thing that they could do right now, especially since they've equaled the kill count, maybe even got one up, and slowly building up this advantage. Now Baloyski facing off against Chico Guy. Gotta say, love the mechanics on Chico Guy early on. He used the tail end of the ult, and Momo goes down. So does the turret. He's going to try to look for a small camp as well, try to bait out a face check from Kyrie.
Yeah, but you can see Kyrie, he's got the whole posse with him. And yes, the super position reveals Chico Guy's position. And quickly with the guiding wind, they had an escape plan ready and it works out. And as you mentioned, Dolarski still having a pretty fun time with Formaze on that top side, completely isolating him from the situation because now he's way too tanky. And even dropping the falling star move, he's winning out this trade very heavily. But Formaze, he trades back as quickly as he can. He gets the regenerate as the rest of Todak as well as Onyx continue to path towards topside.
Yums has just been visiting here. He's everywhere, just the same as Dolarski is, but now Kyrie and Hatred coming up. Oh, it's four men!
Well, they want it, but I don't think it's not gonna happen. Wait, Baloyski actually flickering forward to try and pick it up. Four men flickering out, dies straight away to the immense burst damage of Nibiru's passion with the help of Kyrie at the same time. This is top tier one.
Onyx Philippines is putting up a mobile fusillade. It's essentially just a walking phalanx, and it's Baloyski who sets it up like a spear. He uses that holy baptism, stunning one, maybe two, resulting in this kill squad of four. Right now, down bottom, there's another 2v2. It's a tag team match.
Yep, they're going to find Farmus straight away. Chico doesn't really want to continue this fight. Farmus has already dropped his ult. Any other spells being wasted on him really doesn't matter. But you can see that Onyx is having a great time. They even get another turtle for themselves. That's going to be 2-to-1 turtles in favor of Onyx Philippines.
There's a good amount of Uncanny Valley coming in. But here we go again! The Fusillade Assault! It's going to be Baloyski with that surprise holy baptism, putting it in for Onyx PH one more time, 3-6. I was about to say, I'm liking how the lane swap has gone for Onyx Philippines because look, now Dolarski can go down and it's a much safer lane. Todak is forced to keep Formaze safe. He just did not have a great early game.
Yeah, I mean, Formaze, despite being a level up on, honestly, on Dolarski for the largest, a good amount of time, I'm surprised that it has turned out this way for Onyx. I thought, at the very least, not Esmeralda, but, you know, maybe the Beatrix as well, as just Kyrie will start controlling this game. And yes, it did, but not in the way that I thought. But so far, it's not looking good here for Todak as they desperately try to hold on towards their tier one, managing to get the Fissure down to clear up that way. Baloyski will take the damage, but honestly, for me, I think Baloyski is making a significant difference here.
Yeah, he earlier on was trying to help Onyx confirm kills, and I guess this is more of a lethal Rafaela. It's less the Rafaela that just tries to save you this whole time. That's why I think Todak was ahead in kills, is because it's Onyx who is also on the assault. It's also Onyx who understood that they might have to be the beatdown. Now, my next question is, where's Marky going to go with this Faramis? He's always just been going one-on-one against Momo, and so far, they've just always been playing an isolated matchup.
Yeah, I think it's about scaling, possibly. What do you think, LaFell?
Okay, so here's the problem with Team Toda. They should have gotten more kills earlier in the game because we can see that the damage from Chiku is very strong. Alucard is a very strong early game hero, but right now, an engage on to Team Toda.
For Maze, he gets hit by the Holy Baptism, but luckily takes a guiding win. This means that mid-tier 1 is going down. You force the flicker on out of there. Onyx PH continue to exert pressure and control over the map.
Yeah, and just as I was saying, Team Toda, they do have scaling heroes. They do have the Brody as well as the Lunox, but they really should respect the Beatrix as well as the Nathan. They scale even better. So if they had a better engaged hero, maybe swap something out with the Matilda, like something like a Cho or something. But right now, Marky is getting attacked.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they just have to farm him as much as they can because he is going to be the weak link because he is directly designed for team fights and to counter glue for a large majority of this game.
Yep, and I'm looking at Chiku Guy. I'm wondering if he understood what his actual role is. Earlier on, I agree with LaFell. They should have made more of that opening. They should have made more of the fact that Chiku Guy can bait out these team fights wherein Onyx thought that they could win, but right now, obviously, that's not the case. Look at this, Chiku Guy is out of position. He's so deep in that they couldn't even contest for Lord.
Yeah, I think at this point of time, we have to understand that Chiku... Wait, hold on. He's going straight on to Marky once again. Is he going to secure the kill? Yes, he does. And he's going to get out with the help of Yunz's guiding winds. But down on towards the mid side, towards that tribe rush, we're seeing that Marky is getting held hostage here. His Moon wants to get out. Brilliance is already popped in there. Just going to run him down. Beloyski doesn't want to continue any further. Calls the team to pull back. Focus on what's important. We got Lord. We don't have to force the situation.
Because of that whole pull by Todak deeper into their jungle, a turret was taken down up top. I think that's a small Requiem, a small Recluse for Todak. Like, that's a lane pushed for free. Another one down bottom too, but yep, this is a huge push by Onyx up top.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they have to try their best here. I don't think they're going to force. Here comes the Falling Star Moon coming in from Dlarski. Momo tries to get in the middle. Nibiru's Passion has been baited out. And split. You can see even the tiny little bit of goo is not enough. Dlarski, whoa, that's a lot of damage coming in from both Chiku guys as well as Moon. You're seeing the scaling starting to come into effect here for Toda.
I'm slightly frustrated with Momo.
Mm-hmm.
I think he should be diving Nathan and Beatrix, but he just couldn't find it. I don't blame him. It's just the way Onyx PH is playing. Beloyski's not giving him a chance. And again, Chiku Guy is isolating Marky, finding him the weak link. But just the same, I think he's still playing his role.
Yeah, I mean, that's the idea. Keep him distracted. Whoa, that damn Moon nearly exploding under the damage coming in from a farm. I wasn't ready for that one. That kind of, that shook me to my core. It's not going to be easy as Dlarski and Beloyski. Oh, they find it. Two alts already being used, Flying Star Moon as well as the Holy Baptism. But this is Yums we're talking about. He's building full tank. He can eat it now.
Yeah, right now what we can see that Team Toda is doing, they're actually separating their own team, trying to play the side lanes, trying to slow down the game a little bit more because they want to take something from the Onyx ID way of beating Onyx Philippines. Wait it out. They will eventually make a mistake around Lord and try to capitalize on that.
Oh, that's what we're talking about. Beloyski now getting attacked, falling in straight into the Nibiru's Passion, but no majority, no important members getting caught in the fire against it. Hatred, I mean, he's doing a really good job here overall with these Nibiru's Passions, but so far, what do you think, Leo, can Onyx PH, what they should be looking for as Chiku now can't seem to get out of this situation. He's so deep into enemy lines and a great super position coming in from Kairi to ensure that Chiku is going to be slain.
That's one way of doing it. Chiku guys got away with the whole, okay, I'll bait you out, surprise my old son. That's why he's gone 5-0-X so far. But this one time that Onyx just collapsed on him, he got punished. And that's a lot of gold, honestly. You shut down someone with 5 kills straight, that's a lot of gold. So that's explaining this 5k gold lead still by Onyx despite going 7-7. And Dlarski's gonna catch the Circling Eagle.
Mm-hmm. Circling Eagle's already abused the same goals for the Darkening coming in. Split fast. Coming in from Momo, they realized that after the position from Dlarski flickering out of that was done, they couldn't get back on top of him.
Onyx PH, the name of the game for them right now is lane management. They just need to keep this in check. And just like the way that I'd say Cade drafted their victory against Onyx, they had good coverage. Now they have much better coverage. I like how LaFell referenced how Onyx ID defeated Onyx PH earlier. That's what they did. But now I think it's on Onyx PH's side, actually. There's two marksmen there. for crying out loud. Two marksmen, and it's so much easier to force out these long fights, especially with Rafaela.
Yeah, I mean, just look at the positions that they're playing from. Mid is getting pushed out. We have Formase down on bot side clearing up those waves. We're seeing that, you know, Torak, they cannot look to hard, always hard face check this because there's such pressure coming in from ADH's side. They want to play for this Luminous Lord, and I think it's going to be a make it or break it for either one of these teams. 39, oh, holy baptism on towards Yum's side, forcing him back. That's two ultimates down. This might be an opportunity for Todak, but no, they're going to completely give up this Luminous Lord.
That was honestly faster than I expected. Did not notice that Onyx PH was clearly present in bottom lane. That two-man fusillade attempt was just enough to make Todak think that Onyx PH was going to commit, and then poof, right from underneath their noses, Luminous Lord.
Yeah, it's still pretty shocking here, but LaFell, now that before Lord gets anywhere close towards Todak's space, what can they do to turn this around?
Right now, Moon has to step up. He can clear the lane very, very well. Same with Formase on his Brody. Right now, we're at 14 minutes. This is their time to shine, but we do have to see how Momo or Yums will try to set things up. I want to see more from Moon and more from Formase, and actually, Chiku Blue just waiting just to get destroyed. At least the Beatrix, and then they should be able to defend this.
Mm-hmm. Bennett's Rage already being used as they're looking to try and open up another inhibitor here. They clear up the waves relatively nicely. They still have bottom side and top side pushing in, but it's one lane not to worry about here. But look at the damage coming in from Onyx. They should be able to shred it relatively fast. They're not getting too much so far. Antique Res being purchased by Kyrie is now looking to try and catch on Chiku, guys. The Holy Baptism does not connect. Marky maybe in a little bit of trouble. He goes down to Formase, and now the initiation has begun. Yums trying to get in towards that backline, gets on top of Dolarski, but it doesn't really matter. This Chiku guys hops on towards the wrong targets here. He cannot kill that backline. Moon, unfortunately, cannot get deep enough. Flickers away, giving up that position to Onyx PH to start walking in towards the base. Momo has to do his best. He was already in the split quickly at the last second, gets onto Dolarski, pushes him out, and now Moon with the targeting takes out the rest. Hatred is down. Dolarski walks away, but Dolarski does not care. He's disrespecting the enemies, knowing that they cannot deal with how tanky he absolutely is, as Momo trying his best to hold on with anything. Yums will be able to come back up, but he cannot clear that wave. That this should be it here, and they know it. Yums can only do his very best, and Onyx PH will savor these last couple of seconds. GG, well played to the Philippines, Onyx PH.
Back to back, there were moments there where the crazy call, the play to stay and say, we're gonna trade, we're gonna force this, either on the defense or the offense, could have paid off. But in this case, Onyx Philippines were all the more aware of what cards they were able to play and how much of a threat they were in that situation, which led to their victory.
Right now, I would say, unfortunately, Todak felt the wrath of the revenge from Onyx Philippines.
Oh, yeah.